everyone. Hope you're having a great day so far. Wanted to hop on and talk to you guys about this. When you put God first in your life, He will align your desires with His desires, and He will bring that stuff to pass in His timing. Now, the key to this is you've got to be putting God first in your life above your own desires, because when you do that, He will then add all the things unto you that you need for your life. But a lot of times the mistake that we make is we put our desires first and we're not seeking God first in our life. And when we do that, we can get counterfeit blessings in our lives, which is why we have to be extremely careful, you guys. And you know, God can shift and align your desires differently in different seasons according to when you're ready and according to the plans that He has for you. Wanted to remind you guys of this scripture today. This is Matthew 6:33. It says, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and then all these things shall be added unto you." And so a lot of times we will go chasing after the things that we want instead of chasing after God with all of our hearts. You know, we'll go chasing after that job. We'll go chasing after that relationship. We'll go chasing after, pick whatever it is, that financial opportunity, you know, and we'll go chasing after that stuff first instead of chasing after Jesus. But here's the problem with that, you guys. When you go try to establish that stuff first before you're really established with Jesus meeting those needs in your life first and foremost, what can happen is you can settle for a counterfeit. Because when we seek God first, what happens is then He aligns His desires for our life with our desires for our life. And that's how you don't get these counterfeit blessings that the devil is trying to send into your life. And, you know, rather, that's when we do get the real deal from God that He's trying to send. That's a good gift. Amen. And so I wanted to throw out a few examples of this from my personal life and from others that I've heard of, ministers' lives or whatever. So I wanted to start off with one story of how a minister, God was talking to him about a change in season where him and his family were going to be uprooted and moved to a different location. And so this minister was having a God time with the Lord, and he was praying, and all of a sudden God just put this desire on his heart to leave this specific region that they were living in. And it just came kind of out of nowhere. You know, it was kind of sudden that this desire came up to move out of this region. He felt a big peace about it. You know, it was just something that God was telling him, I'm moving you, I'm calling you to a different location, kind of a thing. And it was his desire. It was not like God was telling him, this is your next move. He had a heart desire for it first, and then God confirmed it and said, listen, you're about to move. I've not called you to be in this territory anymore. So he goes home to tell his wife, and he goes, and then he shows up in front of his house, and he sees that there's a for sale sign in the front yard, and he goes, what on earth happened while I was gone? And so he walks in, and he goes, honey, why is there a for sale sign in the front yard? And she said, well, the landlord stopped by, and he said, we've got 30 days to get out. And that's when he was able to open up to his wife and go, oh my gosh, this is for sure confirmation. God just told me we're about to move, you know? And so it's interesting that God moved on this guy's heart desire to go to a different location. And then he gave him the instruction, and then God ended up bringing it to pass, you know? And so a lot of times when we are seeking God first in our lives, this only works when you are trying to keep God at the forefront and when you are surrendering to everything to Him, allowing Him to be the Lord of your life, not trying to manipulate things yourself. But when you do that, your desires will align with the Lord, and He can bring you and pull you into what He has for you. Another silly example from the same minister that was a great example of God aligning his heart desires with the Lord's in the right timing was when it came to him meeting his spouse. You know, he was a very godly guy, and he ended up marrying a very godly gal, and they had been friends through church for years, you know, before anything ever happened. And what happened was they connected spiritually on a really deep level, to the point where it was kind of eerie. Like, he could even tell when she walked in the room. He could tell what her mood was, all this stuff, because they had just reached such a deep, intimate place in prayer. And they both were a little bit weirded out by it for a while. And they kind of went through this season of, is it yes, is it no, all of this stuff. And so the guy started praying about this with God. And he said, what is going on here? You know, like, why is something so different when it comes to this person? And so he was just praying, you know, for what to do with this situation. But the problem was, he wasn't like particularly attracted to this girl. He didn't think that she was ugly by any means, you know, but it just wasn't his normal type that he went for, so to speak. And so he said, God, you know, we're already connected spiritually as one almost, you know. And he said, so if this is my wife, you know, you're going to have to align my desires with this. And sure enough, pretty soon after he prayed that prayer, it's like God turned the light bulb on and he was physically attracted to his future spouse, and they ended up getting married and they did it God's way, you know. But there was a season for that. There was a season where God, you know, opened his eyes, and they knew each other for a while before God appointed that particular marriage to come to pass. And so that's an example. You know, I've had times in my own personal life, for example, there was a season, gosh, 5 years ago now, it's been a while, where God was telling me to move to a particular city. And before that, I just had a strong desire to be in this certain territory, you know. It wasn't anything that I had heard from the Lord. It was just, you know, I really wanted to be in this particular area. And, you know, after that, you know, God gave the specific instruction of, yes, I'm calling you to this territory. You are going to move there. And I moved there and was happy there for quite a while. Well, then, you know, several months ago, this started to happen to me where I just lost the desire to be in this particular territory. You know, I just did not want to be there anymore. And I couldn't describe it. It was, you know, it wasn't that I was particularly upset about anything. It was just my desire to be in that city just kind of, you know, went away. And I had this desire to move kind of a thing. And, you know, God then showed me, no, I'm not calling you here. I am about to step you into this next season of transition in your life. And so when we are seeking God first, this only works when we're seeking God first, and we still need to test things. We still need to run it through the scripture test. We still need to not make hasty decisions, you know. But a lot of times God will remove heart's desires, and he will put on you heart's desires when it is the appointed time in the appointed season for a lot of different things. And he can do this in all kinds of ways. You know, I've talked to couples, I have not personally experienced this yet, who, you know, they got married and they didn't have a desire for kids, you know, for a while. But then when it was the right season, it hit them. And all of a sudden, these people who didn't really think that they wanted kids, you know, decided that they wanted to have kids. And so you can apply this in all kinds of different areas of our life. But the only way that this works is not when we seek the blessing first. It's when we seek God first. It's when we seek his will over our life. Because when we do that, God then puts his desires on our heart and they become our desires. And then he fulfills those things because it's what's best for us and it's what's good for us. And so this has been a transition season for a lot of different people. I've been talking to a lot of different people, and this has been a very common theme, is transition has been going on in a lot of people's lives right now. And so I want to tell you guys, put God first. That's the most important part. This scripture I just read you from Matthew 6:33 says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Then all these things, these blessings, those needs that you have in your life will be added unto you. And God's going, you know what, for some of you guys, the reason that you have not been moving forward faster is because your emphasis has been on the things. Your emphasis has been on getting what you want rather than on focusing on the Lord. But when you focus on the Lord, scripture says no good thing will he withhold from those who love him, you know? And so when we put our focus on God first, that's when stuff gets added unto us. That's when no good thing gets withheld. So we can either try to do it in our own strength, or we can focus on God, trust him with these things, and in the right timing, he will add those things unto us. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.